Hi everyone, and welcome back to the third part of Lesson 7, Level 1. In this video, we'll look at what we refer to as Excel tables and some of the functionality that they contain. Picking up from the last video where we got all of our data sorted and nicely formatted, what you could call this is what's referred to as a flat file. This book goes as far as to call it a flat file database, but after spending 5 years as a database administrator, this phrase would insult me if I wasn't so good-natured. Either way, I'm going to call it just a flat file. Up to this point in the class, we referred to this group of cells as a table, but it's really just an unstructured group of cells in its current state. With this unstructured group of cells, we can very easily and accidentally mess it up, or in database ease, ruin its integrity. Let me show you what I mean. It's very common for beginners to break the table by sorting it incorrectly. If I want to sort this group of cells by the address column, it's very easy to just click on the address column, go to the data, and then sort it in an ascending manner by clicking on this A to Z icon right here. Excel is smart enough to know that you're most likely doing something wrong here, so this warning pops up telling you that you haven't selected all of the surrounding data in this group of cells. So it lets you save yourself by selecting this Expand the Selection button here, and then you'd be okay. However, if you just continue with the current selection, watch what happens to our previously sorted data, where each row contains all the data about one particular customer. Notice here, Blue Sports Marketing is located at 9209 Tongass Avenue, right? After I click the Sort button, all the addresses are now sorted alphabetically, but none of the surrounding data was sorted along with it, and Blue Sports' address is now 101 6th Avenue. So it's now all messed up and wrong. I'm going to undo this so that all can be right in the world again. Phew, I feel better now, I was getting stressed. The lesson from this is that even though the data looks like a table, it's really just an unstructured range of cells where the integrity of the data in that cell range is easily messed up. Fortunately for us, Excel allows us to take this unstructured group of cells and impose some structure on it so that it's easier to work with. We'll call this new structure an Excel table. An Excel table is treated as a single unit of data as opposed to just a collection of individual cells. Before I use the table wizard to convert this group of cells into an Excel table, I want to make sure that there isn't any extra data out here to the left, to the right, on the top of this data set, or down on the bottom of it, because if there is, Excel will make the table wider or longer than it really should be. We want the table to be just the right height and width of all this data, nothing extra. Now that we've verified that we have a nice cleanly defined group of cells, I need to make sure that my cursor is on any cell in the middle of that group, and then I just go up to Insert, and then click here on Table. This wizard automatically finds the limits of the cell range, and then just to make sure that if your data has headers, like ours does, that this checkbox is checked. I'll hit OK, and voila! Automatically the table takes on a whole new look. Not only is it nicely formatted with this lovely varied blue shading, but more importantly, each row is now grouped together as one customer, and it's pretty tough to break apart. We also now have a lot of new functionality embedded into this column header row. We can alter the look of the table by going up to the table design ribbon and selecting one of these other table styles. We can pick one of these icky orange ones. That's the last thing we need though, is a gator colored table. Or we could spend some time to create a garnet and gold style table, but life's too short and my favorite color is blue, so blue it is. We can also give this Excel table a name over here, so I'll call it Alaska Customers, in case I want to refer to this table in some formula on another worksheet at a later time. It may be important to note that an Excel table takes up a bit more memory in Excel than just a large group of cells, so the size of a table is actually limited to 1,048,576 rows and 16,384 columns. Also, extremely large tables will cause your Excel file to slow down quite a bit, so please keep this in mind when you're using them. Let's look at the functionality contained in these drop-down arrows now located in all of our header row cells. Sorting by any column is now extremely easy. We can just click on either of these choices and the table will sort itself accordingly, and all of the columns for all the customers remain tied together. We can also go back into here and sort by color if we have any of these cells shaded with any colors for any reason. Additionally, we can go to the full sorting wizard by clicking on the custom sort choice here, and we then have the option of doing a multi-level sort like we did in the last video. These checkboxes here allow us to look at any individual city or any combination of cities in our Excel table. For instance, if we want to just look at the customers in Fairbanks, we uncheck this Select All box, and then come down here and check Fairbanks and hit OK. Now our table only displays the customers in Fairbanks. The other customers in the table are still there, but they're just hidden from our display. Look over here on the left, see our row numbers? 2 through 40 and 57 through 102 are now invisible to us. I can filter this data set down even further if I want to. For instance, if I want to only show the customers in 99501, I can go over to the zip column and filter on that particular zip code as well. For alphanumeric data, you can additionally filter using any of these advanced filter choices, and for numeric data, you have a different advanced filter mechanism available to you. If we had a date column in our table, there would also be some pretty cool date filtering options for us to play with as well. To remove these filters, just go back to each column drop-down arrow that now looks like this tiny little filter, and then either click on Select All, Clear Filter from Zip, or if you're into keyboard shortcuts, you can just click on the C on your keyboard. We also need to remove the filter from the City column here by doing the same thing, and we're back to displaying our entire table. Let's explore some additional embedded table functionality by going back up to our Design ribbon and look here in the Table Style Options section here. We have this total row option right here. If we select this checkbox, we now get a new row at the bottom of our table that has lots of options for us. By default, we get this row counter over here on the right-hand column of our table, and it tells me that there are 101 customers in this table. By clicking on this 101 cell, we get a drop-down list that gives us some choices. Some of these choices don't necessarily make sense, since it wouldn't make any sense to find the average of these phone numbers, but that's where our intelligence kicks in. We could also select any of these other choices, but we'll just stick with count. Now that we have our total row enabled, let me show you how it reacts when I filter the data again. I'll go back up to the top, and in the city column, I'll filter it again by Fairbanks. See how the total automatically updates? You can also have more than one column totaled in the totals row. If I click on the zip column here and select the average value, we get the average value of the zips currently displayed. While this numerical average of a range of zip codes may not tell us anything, since the zip code may not even exist in America, this does show you the numerical functionality available to us, so please forgive me on this data faux pas. We can delete this total row by unchecking our checkbox back up in the Design ribbon if we want to. Let me show you how to insert data into an Excel table. We can do it in a couple of ways. If we want to add a column somewhere, we go to the spot just to the right of where we want to add that column and right-click. Select Insert, and then Table Columns to the left. If we want to insert a row or multiple rows in the middle of the table, we can do it like this. Say I want to add 5 rows here after this customer. I want to select 5 rows immediately below that row, and then select Insert, and then Table Rows Above. If I want to add rows to the bottom of the table, I go down to the last row and to the far right column and then hit the Tab key, and Excel will just append a row at the bottom of the table. A handy feature that I can show you while I'm here that I could use if I needed to here would be if I wanted to reuse an existing customer name in this cell. I could right-click on this cell and this pick from drop-down list to see all the existing values in that column. If I need to delete a row, I just go to that range of cells, right-click, delete, and then table rows. Finally, if you want to copy and paste a large number of rows onto the bottom of the table, you have to remove the header row, and then I'll copy a bunch of these rows just as an example. I'll then go to the first row after the bottom of the table, and all I do is do a Control V to paste the rows here, and the table automatically enlarges itself as needed. Now I'll re-add the total rows to get me back to the way I want it. If you get the data manipulated into just the exact way you want it, and then want to do away with the Excel table structure, you can do that very easily. Go up to the Table Design ribbon, go over to the Tools section on this page, and then select the icon Convert to Range. Notice that when we do this, the formatting is still there, and even the totals row is still semi-functional, as it converted all of those totals into subtotal formulas, so they'll still work for us. Well, that's it for Level 1 of Lesson 7. The next level will have us importing data from a database and learning about pivot tables. So I'll see you there.